Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel, or hi if you're new here. This is my first video of 2021, which is kind of crazy to say. I wanted to do a cozy vlog style video to start things off, where I'm just taking you guys along with me as I reset and get reorganized for the new year. I know it's not for everybody, but I really love the idea of a fresh start. But I totally advocate for having a fresh start at any time in the year, whenever you get the motivation to do so. But now is just the prime opportunity for me, I feel like. And maybe for you too. I feel like for the end of 2020, my mind was just a jumbled mess. I wouldn't say I was disorganized completely. I always knew where everything was and what was going on and all the things that I needed to get done. But my brain was kind of a disaster. So working on fixing all of that, I'd started developing some bad habits with eating too much takeout and not really exercising when I got busy. So I want to work on changing that. I would love to hear from you guys what your goals are for the new year, if you've set any, and we can have a nice little chat in the comments below. Before I continue anymore, I want to thank the sponsor of this video, which is Ritual. You guys have heard me talk about Ritual before. I've been taking their vitamins for over a year now, and I'm so excited to be working with them on another video. It's always cool to work with brands that I am personally a customer of. Even with a perfect diet, it can be hard to get the nutrients that we need on a daily basis, and that's where Ritual comes in. Ritual is an obsessively researched multivitamin that's vegan friendly, sugar free, non-GMO, gluten free, and allergen free. I love that transparency is at the core of everything that Ritual does. Everything from the way that nutrients are sourced to the environmental impact of the materials that are used to ship thousands of orders. Their bottles are made with 100% recycled materials. It's delivered to your door subscription, so it's super easy and convenient. I find that something like vitamins can really slip away from you, so it's amazing to have this automated. And it's only a dollar a day to have 9 high quality nutrients that your body needs delivered to you every month. Before I started taking Ritual, I was taking several different vitamins rather than a multivitamin, and I found that that had me skipping days kind of out of laziness or forgetfulness. I hadn't really formed a great habit around taking vitamins. Also, the vitamins that I was taking did not taste good and they were quite big. The Ritual vitamins are smaller capsules, and the vitamins actually come with this mint tab inside that keep the vitamins smelling super fresh, and it also makes them taste good. So I take the Essential for Women vitamins, but they have a men's multivitamin, a 50 plus vitamin, a prenatal vitamin, postnatal vitamin, and teen vitamins. Ritual is actually offering you guys 10% off your first 3 months. To redeem the offer, you can go to ritual.com/kaileemm10 and use the code kaileemm10. I'll have that information in the description box below. Thank you so much to Ritual for partnering with me on this video, and now we'll get into the vlog. So like I said, this vlog is just kind of me getting my life together, resetting for the new year. There are 2 days left in this year right now, which I can't believe tomorrow is New Year's Eve. It's gonna be such a different New Year's Eve than normal. Obviously, I think I'm just doing a little like double date situation with one of my close friends, so that'll be fun. And we're obviously just gonna stay in. I don't think you really can even go out, although I somehow still see so many people that I follow on social media going out. But I've been an extra homebody this break, and it's been so, so nice. So it's the 30th now. I took like 5 days off for Christmas, which was incredible. I've never really even done that before, like been completely off customer service emails. I'm so glad I did that because I feel like I was a bit on the brink of burnout. Starting fresh for the new year, I really want to get more organized. I feel like my brain would just be a lot clearer and I would be happier if I took the time to do the organizational tasks and set up my life to be more efficient and easier for myself. So that's what I've been working on the past few days. Loving it so far. I finally got a planner. I used to have planners when I was in school, and for the past few months I've just been having like a sheet of paper that I use as like my planner. I've tried a few different apps to use, and like I've tried to use Google Calendar as my calendar, but I really don't like it for some reason, which is odd because I like having everything else digital, but for that it just doesn't work that well for me, I feel. But I got this Erin Condren vegan leather planner just on Amazon. It's like like a super simple layout, like a to-do list section, like a weekly and monthly view, and notes sections. I think it's great so far, and I really wanted something simple. And I really like the size of it as well, so I'll link this down below for you guys if you're interested. The past couple days, I've also been cleaning out like any junky sort of drawers and like areas of my pantry in my apartment. I also got some container store credit for the holidays, which I'm super grateful for. And I placed an order and went and picked up some stuff. Got like some fridge and pantry and drawer organization for my clothes. And I also got some new hooks to go on the back of my closet. So most of that stuff is in place now. Feels really nice. Maybe not as nice as I thought that it would though. I love having an organized space, but I'm definitely not like one of those, with all respect, container store like freaks, you know? Not even an insult. I've also started installing like new lighting in my apartment. My boyfriend got me some Hue light bulbs as one of my Christmas presents with the hub. So now I control the lights in my apartment from my phone. I also just bought some more so they could be all over my place. And it's great, so now all my lights can dim. I just got some bulbs where I can add some colored light when I choose, like some red light to my bathroom. Just made everything so much cozier. I really love those. I'll have to show you guys more about how they work sometime in this video. Right now, I'm actually procrastinating, which is something that I don't want to continue to do, but I'm definitely guilty of it. I need to wrap up all of my business finances for the year. It's not like I have zero idea what's going on. I definitely know what's going on. Like, I always have the running list in my head. Like I mentioned earlier, I feel like my brain's just a jumbled mess. Like, I know exactly where everything is and what's happening, but I just need to be a little bit clearer, I think. I need to get those all together. I've really fallen behind on tracking expenses for taxes this year. It's not like I don't know how the finances are, it's just getting things ready for taxes. And I can't figure out why. I'm kind of kicking myself for it now, because there were definitely months of this year when I didn't have that much going on, obviously, with quarantine. And I definitely could have gotten on top of it then, but I didn't for some strange reason. I also want to share some other New Year's goals in this video. I think setting goals is super healthy, and it's completely critical for me, I find, to progress my life in the direction that I want. Oh, another thing that I got that I'm gonna recommend to you guys, even though I haven't been using it, if you are a freelancer or have your own business of any sort, I got these receipt organizers. This is something I've also been very bad at in the past, again with taxes. I mean, honestly, I used to wait until April to even start worrying about last year's finances for taxes, and I'm better now. I'm not the best at keeping track of receipts, so I got two of these also on Amazon, just have a place to store everything so they're not all over my apartment. Yeah, we're getting our life together. Feel really refreshed and nice. That's what we're doing in this video. Feel free to join me. I also just got in some new loungewear pieces, which I'm gonna share with you guys. I feel like that's an area that my wardrobe is seriously lacking, because it's not really something that I find just fun to spend money on. I would rather spend money on like a fun going out top like this, but we're not going out very often right now. Obviously, I post my photos online as a part of my job and like getting dressed and whatever, and I love it so much. I still love to get dressed when I'm at home, but all of my pajamas and loungewear are disgusting. So I did some replacement shopping and I'm gonna share with you guys. Okay, so I placed a kind of large Uniqlo order for loungewear pieces. I have some lounge pants from them that I've had for a couple years that I just like stretched to the end, and they're gross now and like all stained, but I love them so much. So I wanted to pick up some new pieces. I also got some new slippers. I ended up getting two slippers. I only have one here because one pair is at my boyfriend's. And I got these brown corduroy slippers. They're super cushiony and still feel like a bit more put together. I didn't want to get like a pair of furry ones because that's how my current slippers are. And you know, those just get gross. You don't really feel very clean when you're wearing them after a while. So I wanted to get some that would be a little bit easier to keep up with. And I'll have all this stuff linked down below for you guys. My camera really cannot handle this shirt. I have to cover it with my hair. I realized I didn't have any gloves, so I picked up these cashmere gloves because they were on sale and they feel so nice. I also got this black thermal, almost like nightgown. It's a dress, so just like a really big long t-shirt, and it's super thick and cozy. I love wearing thermal shirts without pants to lounge in, so I thought that that could be perfect. Then I also got this gray fuzzy sweater. I got this in size XL. I got most of the stuff in a larger XL. Then I got this gray zip-up hoodie in an XL. I would definitely size up on this unless you want it to be fitted. But kind of who wants fitted lounge clothes? Maybe you do, but I just find it really uncomfortable. This is like a terry on the inside though. It's not a fleece if you're expecting that. I got these black drawstring lounge shorts so I can wear these instead of boyfriend's boxers. And then I also got these striped drawstring lounge pants. I'm excited to be more cozy but still feel put together because I feel like that's been an issue kind of with my self-confidence and mental health. I know everyone is different when it comes to this. Find that in those like sort of slumps of inactivity, I'm just working on the computer all day in the same like ratty kind of clothes that I slept in. It's not cool and it can kind of tank my self-confidence, which maybe is my own problem. But I'm just trying to make myself feel a little bit more put together, so I'm excited to have some nicer loungewear that didn't break the bank in my closet now. Already getting dark outside! It gets dark so early, but we've already had the shortest day of the year. This is my outfit today. I am wearing this Kiko Kostadinov velvet top. It feels very Star Wars, which I love. I love that so much about the Kiko women's wear stuff. It's not totally my style, so I would like never buy something unless it's on end of season sale or secondhand, but I still really love it. I just finished all of The Mandalorian. I loved Star Wars when I was younger. That's a random fact about me. All of the cuts of the clothes feel very Star Wars-esque to me. I'm wearing it with this Schatzwillet necklace sample and our fossilized band, which we're working to restock, and these Sapir Bashar earrings. And then these are the black pants in our new collection. Unfortunately, they're sold out right now, but they are the comfiest things. And then I'm wearing my new slippers. More organized pantry and shelving system. And you guys, my oven has been out of use for 6 months and it's finally fixed and I'm so stoked on that. The next day. This sweater is the best, you guys. I think you need it. I've never worn something more comfortable in my life. So I'm dressed very cozy today. But I did put on makeup, so I'm a bit more put together. And it's New Year's Eve, and I will be getting ready later for our very intimate celebration and eating some Ethiopian food. We'll see what I throw on for that. Today's just a more chill day of getting some stuff done. Very gloomy and dark out there today. Maybe symbolizing the end of this year. But yeah, last night I just did most of my business finances for the year. Like I said earlier, I think I was totally kicking myself for just procrastinating that actually all year. Most of them are done now. I was feeling very tense last night, like reliving the trauma kind of when things weren't so great. The beginning and like middle of the pandemic, we were refunding people so much for lost packages on behalf of USPS, and that was not fun to relive through, but that's okay. I'm gonna make a cozy ramen for lunch, and then my boyfriend's gonna come over. We're gonna hang out until we go over to our friends later. I'm in my office again. I just spent such a long time picking out items for a Farfetch edit that I'm working on. It's like such a fun process, but like the endless scrolling is like kind of eye exhausting. I should have been wearing my blue light glasses, but that should be coming out for you guys soon. I'm working with them later on in the month. Those kinds of things always take me so much longer than I think that they will. I love curating pieces from like a bunch of different brands. I obviously always do that for end of season sales for you guys, and it's so much fun. So it's cool that I'm doing it for them directly. Yeah, I want to finish up work for the day. I wanted to clean out my closet today a bit because I definitely need to sell some pieces soon. I'm out of hangers, which is unacceptable, I've decided, and I'm not buying more hangers, so I need to get rid of some stuff. And there's definitely pieces in my wardrobe that I haven't been wearing lately or just aren't serving me anymore, but they're still nice pieces. So I'm probably going to be doing a sale on Vestiaire again soon and also on Depop. So stay tuned for that. Maybe I'll go through my closet more in this video, but I'm not really feeling it right now. I am feeling a game of chess though. I know I've been talking about chess in all my vlogs. I just got the loveliest marble chess set from my boyfriend for Christmas. I actually cried when I opened it. I'm gonna show you. I've shared it on Instagram. The pieces are so heavy and so beautiful. I really love the knights. Yeah, we were just using one of his family chess sets prior to this and bringing it back and forth between our houses. Now I'm so excited to have one of my own. Feeling pretty cozy in here now, but my tree is dying. I'm waiting to set it out so that it can be set out on one of the composting dates for New York City. I am pretty convinced that I'm allergic to this tree as well, so I'm excited to get it out of here. But it smelled so nice, and I'm sure I'll get another real tree in the future. Morning, I finally cleaned out my closets and I have a bin for Depop and a bin for Vestiaire. So maybe some of that stuff will be up by the time I post this video. If not, it'll be going up soon and I'll have some links down below for you guys. But now I'm gonna shower and get ready and take these photos.
I think I was telling you guys that I just got the new Hue light bulbs. That's something I've been doing just to kind of get my space feeling more cozy and set up. Something that really makes me feel like a homeowner even though I'm just a renter, and it was such an easy swap. I'm so glad he did this for me, but I wanted to show you how they worked and I'll have them linked down below in case you guys are interested. So you have an app, and I just have them in two rooms right now. I have them in my dining room and my office, but I want to get more. I just have the regular ones that don't have color, but I ordered some color ones for my bathroom so that I could have red light if I wanted. But I just flip a switch and then my light just came on, as you can see back there. So it used to look like this when my lights were on in here, which is obviously horrible. I would never turn them on ever. But now I can dim them on my phone. And I usually keep them pretty much all the way down. So I have that for my office too, and I just want them for all of my rooms. Because right now I don't have, you can't even see the light. There we go. So right now I don't have any lamps over there. So when I would have like people over for dinner, we would just have candles and I would have my other lamps turned on, or like playing chess at my table. It was kind of hard to see. So I'm so glad I can turn those lights on now. It was just one of the best gifts ever. So I highly recommend. The light bulbs definitely aren't super cheap. I only have one of them in right now and you can't really even tell that much. There's usually two light bulbs in that light fixture. I think it's quite worth it. And if you have an apartment, you probably don't have that many lights to fix. And I feel like a lot of you guys probably have apartments, but they just connect to your Wi-Fi in a little hub and then you get the app on your phone and it's great. So I had to share that. I know my other light bulbs are at my PO box, so hopefully I'll get them picked up this week and then I can share another update with you guys soon. It just completely transformed my space. I feel like lighting is so crucial, especially if you lived in a smaller space. I feel like this would have saved me so much when I lived in a super tiny apartment about the size of this room for the whole thing with the kitchen and the bathroom. It just would have made things better for me. I'm listening to Jessica Pratt and I'm gonna remove the bulbs from my Christmas tree. On my couch now in one of the new like thermal sort of nightgowns that I got from Uniqlo that I shared with you guys. And I wanted to talk about New Year's goals for 2021 and share some of mine with you guys
and I would love to hear some of yours in the comments below. I'm not sure if the rain outside is peaceful, I have my window cracked, or if it's annoying, but I'm just gonna leave it open because it sounds really nice for me, so I hope you don't mind. So I set personal goals and then I set work goals. And work goals I divided up into my business and then like this whole social media thing, things that I wanted to accomplish. But I'm gonna start with my personal goals. And my personal goals, I didn't separate out financial goals, but I think that that could also be helpful. But where do I even begin? The first one that I wrote down was I wanna speak with a therapist 3+ times a week. I have a system with the current therapist that I'm working with. I've been working with her for 4 months now, which is kind of crazy. I can't believe I actually started therapy. I'm really glad I did. But I definitely go through phases of time where I'm not using it and getting my full amount of money's worth. I use Talkspace as a system. I'll leave a referral credit down below. You guys can get like $200 off or something, and then I also get a $200 credit towards therapy, so I would totally appreciate that. If it's something that you're looking into, I really love the woman that I was paired with, and we can chat over video or over messaging, and she talks to me every day, so it's really great for me. Some that I've kind of already mentioned in this video, I want to cook more meals, less takeout, and to kind of solidify that into an actual goal, I said cook 4 to 5 dinners per week, and I really want to like start implementing new recipes, looking those up regularly, and also meal prepping. I wrote continue to read. That's not really like a super solid goal, but it's not something that is incredibly important to me, and it's already kind of a habit, so I didn't feel like I needed to solidify that one. I have go to a doctor. I'm hoping that I can make it to a couple doctors. I hate the doctor. I'm terrified of the doctor. Haven't been to the doctor in a very long time. I don't even remember ever getting like a general checkup as a child. So I really need to go. I haven't been since I was in college and could utilize my school's doctor. So I haven't been in a few years. I really want to get blood work done. I've never had blood work done in my entire life. So I kind of want to get that checked out. And I need to find a dentist to go to. Haven't been there in a few years. So that's just like a really big goal of mine, actually, which might sound silly to some people, but I'm gonna do it. I went to an eye doctor this year, and that was a big step for me. And I got a therapist. Oh my gosh. Classic exercising one. I have it on here for 3 to 5 times a week. Started hiking a lot more in the last year, so I want to continue to do that. Get my dog, which hopefully will be happening in the spring. I have a certain amount of money that I want to save, go towards a property, and hopefully the kind of near future, but not this year. I wrote continue to pay my credit card in full each month. I want to take some online classes. I want to get art for my walls because that's something I've been putting off. And then I also wrote that I want to get better at chess. So I feel like those are all pretty simple. The doctor one is definitely a big step, but everything else feels, maybe my money saving goal is a bit high, but I think I can do it, especially if the world gets a little bit better. For my business, outside of this business, I have a certain revenue goal, a lot of like numbers related goals, which I won't share with you guys, but I think they're important to make. I want to get a fulfillment center. Oh my gosh. We've had a fulfillment center for the business when we first started out, and it was a complete and total nightmare, but I think it is time, because I really cannot keep spending all of my time on shipping if I actually want to grow the business, because it's completely impossible, because most of the time it's a one-woman show and I just simply can't anymore. So I'm gonna take the risk and make that step financially feasible, so we're gonna do it. I'm just worried about it messing up our current return policy, which is quite flexible and easy for you guys. I know adding a fulfillment center in the mix makes it so much more expensive, so we'll have to rework that, and it's gonna be a total learning curve and experience, but it's gonna happen. I need to get a new accountant for the business. We need to get the business moved from Avery's hometown in Missouri to New York, which is a total process. I wish we knew this when we were setting it up, but we were just young and dumb. But we have to dissolve our business and start a new one. I hope that we don't have to stop operating during that time, but we have to get an attorney and all new accounts, and it's just gonna be horrible, but hopefully not that horrible. So that's a goal for this year. Trying to move more towards size inclusivity is definitely a goal. Releasing two collections instead of one like this past year is definitely a goal. But I also want to do more community takeovers and just create more of a community on our social media. I really loved doing those over the pandemic, and I know you guys loved them as well. For both my businesses, this is a goal, and it is receipt and finance organization weekly every Friday. No excuses. I must do that. If it doesn't happen on Friday, I have to do it on Saturday. Even though I'm trying to take my weekends off, I am not allowing any exceptions on this one. And you guys can check back in with me next year to see if that happened. And then for this thing on social media, I just have some goals related to clients, like keeping repeat clients, and then also new business. I made percentages for those, and that's something that I've been able to meet the past couple of years, which is great. So many of my clients have been repeat clients, which as a freelancer, if any of you guys are trying to get into freelancing, that is incredibly important. Obviously it depends on the job. If you're performing a service that a client really wouldn't be repeat unless something was wrong, totally different story. But for jobs like this, I feel like at least 50% of your business should be repeat clients. Maybe think about that. And then I also just want to provide more value. I would love to hear more about what you guys want to see from me, because I know I can kind of get into a funk of just doing vlogs on here, but something I really like about vlogs is that I can include just a hodgepodge of topics in them, which I find to be more interesting sometimes and can also be more beneficial. So definitely let me know if there's anything particularly that you want to see from me, and I'll see what I can do. Oh, another personal goal that I didn't write down is that I want to get better at just like responding to people, because that is something I'm not very great at. I don't know why. I should maybe solidify that in some form as well. I've just finished editing this video and I realized I didn't have an outro. So I wanted to say thank you for watching if you made it to the end, and I will see you next week with a new video.